Welcome friends, in this video we are going to study performance metrics for parallel systems, or we are going to analyze the parallel algorithms performance. Okay, now two important notations are there. TP is equal to parallel runtime and TS is equal to serial runtime. So time required for parallel program is TP, time required for serial program is TS. So always remember, we are comparing all the parallel programs or parallel algorithms with the best serial algorithm. Okay, now see, one metric is called as total parallel overhead, that is TO. Now if problem is same, so total parallel overhead is time spent by the parallel program minus time spent by the fastest serial algorithm. Okay, now see, the excess time that parallel program has then the best serial is called as overhead. So overhead TO is equal to PTP minus TS. Okay, so parallel programs time minus serial programs times, that is called as overhead. Now what is P here? P is the processing elements used in the parallel program. Okay, so even though many of the processing elements are running simultaneously, we are calculating the excess time that is spent by some processing elements for parallel programs using PTP. So parallel time is PTP and serial time is TS. Okay, now next one is speed up. Speed up is another metric or the another parameter to check the efficiency or the performance of your parallel system. Okay, so speed up is the ratio of time taken to solve a problem on single processing element to the time required to solve the same problem on the P identical processing elements. Okay, so time for single processing element to the multiple processing elements. So in other words, speed up is equal to time for serial process upon time for parallel process. Okay, we will take one example of 16 elements, addition of 16 elements. Okay, now if serially we add 16 elements, it would take serial time as 16 unit, means we required, if you are calling it as n is equal to 16, so we require theta of n as a serial time. So n is 16, so 16 unit time we required for serial, so that is theta of n. Now parallel time, we can solve it in 4 steps. Okay, so how we can solve? If you want, mention in comment section, I will explain. Okay, so 16 elements can be added in 4 steps using parallel time. So we are denoting it 4 units. So how? Because parallel addition requires log n computation. So log n means log 16 is equal to 4, so 4 units. Okay, so speed up is nothing but the serial time upon parallel time. So serial time is n, we have seen theta of n, so n upon parallel time is log n. So log n, so if you put value of n here, 16, so it will get 16, that is n upon log n, that is log 16 is 4, so it is equal to 4. So speed up is 4. So in other words, your parallel program is 4 times faster than the serial one, so that is called as speed up. So earlier one was overhead, parallel overhead, then speed up. Now next we are going to study efficiency of the parallel program. Okay, now see, efficiency is denoted by capital E. It is measure of fraction of time for which processing element is employed. Okay, so it is nothing but the ratio of speed up to number of processing elements. Okay, so efficiency is formula given, speed up upon processing element. So we are checking how efficient our parallel algorithms are using P processing elements. Okay, so it is nothing but speed up is S and processing elements we are denoting by P. Okay, now the lowest efficiency is 0 and highest it should be 1. Okay, so see, earlier example that we have seen, speed up was theta of n upon log n. Okay, so efficiency is equal to speed up upon number of processing elements. So theta of n log n is the speed up and processing elements are n. Okay, so it would be efficiency is equal to 1 upon log n. Okay.